Hi, welcome to my channel and today I'm going to review 5 cleansers from Indian brands. At first I have this Plum Pore Cleansing Green Tea Face Wash. This face wash has been targeted for combination oily acne prone skin. It has this gel texture. It contains this cellulose beads for scrubbing, which I really don't like much. And this face wash creates moderate foam. They have used sodium lauryl sulfate in there. This is SLES. Please don't confuse it with SLS. SLS is sodium lauryl sulfate. This is sodium lauryl sulfate. I think I have mixed up these two when I reviewed simple moisturizing face wash, which has sodium lauryl sulfate, and I confused it with I think lauryl sulfate. So we have nothing to worry here. Then they have added glycerin, which is a humectant, and then they have used secondary surfactant cocomidopropyl betaine. It's a very mild surfactant. Green tea extract, good. Then glycolic acid. Look, I have tested its pH. It has this pH from 5 to 6, which is a very good pH for gentle face wash. But for glycolic acid to work at its best, it has to have this pH from 3 to 4. 5 to 6 pH, I don't think glycolic acid would work that well as AHA. And they have used very less amount of glycolic acid as well. So as AHA, I don't think it's going to be that effective. I think it's mostly working as pH adjuster. And since they're targeting this for acne prone skin, I would have loved if they have used 2% salicylic acid in there. I think Plum has one toner that has glycolic acid, very low amount of glycolic acid as well. I really wish they come up with salicylic acid toners, like 2% salicylic acid, and they remove fragrance from this toner and their leave-on products. This face wash has fragrance, but this is a wash-up product, so I don't have that much issue here. Okay, then it has cellulose beads. So this is the alternative to plastic beads or micro beads. But I don't like beads in my skincare, I mean in my face wash, because I do chemical exfoliation. Though these beads are very tiny, still I don't like physical exfoliants in my face wash because I'm gonna use this every day. If you don't have any issue with it, then you can go ahead with this face wash. pH is good for acne prone skin. If they would have added salicylic acid, that would have been better. It would be good for, I think, oily combination, even dry skin, because I have used this. I didn't find it drying. It cleaned my skin well, but only reason I'm not gonna use this face wash is that it has these beads, and I don't like beads in my face wash because I want it to be as gentle as possible. Mild, gentle, simple. So there I have this issue. But if you don't have issues with the beads, then you can use this. I think I reviewed it like 3 months back, and there in this video I've said they have used more fragrance than green tea. Maybe they have reformulated this face wash. Whatever it is better now. For acne prone skin, if you're expecting it's gonna help with your acne very well, I don't think it's gonna be that capable. But this is a decent face wash, I guess, if only you have no issues with these beads. So yeah. Up next I have Requel Oil Control Face Wash, and I got this for free because I purchased their hair mask, shampoo and conditioner, and there was this offer going on Nykaa. They gave this for free. If you want to get this face wash for the first time, I encourage you to get this small size to know if your skin likes it or not. It has this gel texture and creates moderate foam. It has cocomidopropyl as the first surfactant, and it has two more surfactants. They've used zinc PCA, which can work for acne and irritated skin. Then they have added some glycols, and okay, I forgot to tell you, Plum, they have used phenoxyethanol as their preservative. No, this is not Plum, this is Kaya, sorry. Okay, retake. Plum has used phenoxyethanol as their preservative, and Requel have used potassium sorbet and sodium benzoate as preservatives, and it was a decent cleanser. It doesn't have any beads, so I like it more than Plum, personal preference. It felt very gentle on my skin. It was not over drying. But yeah, they have used fragrance in this face wash, but this is a wash up thing, so I don't have that much of an issue. I really wish that Plum and Requel, they should come up with one like fragrance free line. I'm gonna write to them, and I encourage you to write to them if you want a fragrance free skincare, because they are trying to use good ingredients. I really want to try their things, Requel and Plum. And Plum, they have few issues with some of their ingredients, but they are trying to use good ingredients, even Requel. So I really would love that if they come up with fragrance free line. And for this face wash, it is a very decent face wash. I like this. It doesn't feel drying. It was a very basic face wash, but don't expect miracle from this face wash. It may control sebum secretion, but for acne you need additional help, but it can be a very decent cleanser to begin with. So up next I have Moha face wash. This is very affordable, but it has some issues. I have tried this face wash, my face really felt dry. The texture is between not too thick, not too thin, and it creates a good amount of foam. But my skin feels so dehydrated and dry after using this. Look at my fingers, they look so dehydrated. It comes in this tube, and on this tube it is written that it has neem and aloe. If you see the ingredients list, you will find these are the last ingredients actually, and it contains more fragrance than these ingredients. They have used sodium lauryl sarcosinet. Don't confuse it with SLS again. This is not SLS, and even Kaya, they have used this surfactant. Then cocamidopropyl betaine, and Kaya have used aloe vera leaf juice as the second ingredient, where Moha have used aloe vera powder as their second last ingredient. But they have used rose, okay, as third ingredient, but we don't know what they're using. Rose extract, rose oil, rose water, what? We don't know that. The ingredients list, not bad. I mean, for the price point, it is decent. The pH is good, 5 to 6, but it can be way better. They have used phenoxythanol as a preservative. Perfume comes way up in the ingredients list. As I have said, they have added more fragrance than aloe and neem. This actually can be a very good face wash if they bring the fragrance at the bottom, and if they make it more gentle. They have used sodium hydroxide as pH adjuster. As I told you, pH is fine for this face wash, but I won't recommend this because I really felt this drying on my skin, and the smell is very overwhelming for my taste. So I'm not gonna be recommending this. This is very budget friendly, which I really love, because people are asking me to make like affordable skincare, and understand that. And I'm looking very hard to find affordable options, and I really wanted it to work, but I would give it a pass for this reason. Felt really drying on my skin. So next, Kaya Youth Hydro Gentle Face Wash, and this packaging, it looks so similar to Body Shop Tea Tree line. So I've used makeup revelation niacinamide. I like it, and they have copied everything from Ordinary, the packaging, the formulation, everything. Skincare revelation niacinamide, they have done it, copied everything. So if the formulation is good, I can be generous. Even Dot & Key, they have copied the entire packaging from Fordia. So it goes on, I think, here. Let me point out the positive things first. They have added niacinamide, then gentle surfactants, aloe vera leaf juice, betaine, anti-aging, very good, mannitol, which can be moisturizing. But then they added perfume. I don't have issue with the perfume in a wash up product, but they have used this fragrant component, which is hexacinamide, and it is known to be an irritant, so they could have skipped this. But this is a wash up product, so okay. But they could have skipped this, right? They have added these beads.
The cellulose beads that Kaya is using, they feel really harsh on the skin. And if I compare this to Plum beads, those are gentle, more gentle than Kaya. Personally, I don't like any physical exfoliants to be present in my face wash. On the top of that, Kaya cellulose beads, they felt kinda harsh on my skin, and I cannot use this on my skin. That is even in a face wash which is designed to be used on daily basis.
The pH is good, but the beads are making me really uncomfortable, so I'm not gonna use this. I really hope that they reformulate it without the beads and this hexacinamide, and it can be a really good face wash because they have used good ingredients. Last, we have Aroma Magic Neem Tea Tree Face Wash. Honestly, I don't have good experience with Aroma Magic products. I have used many things from Aroma Magic when I was in college. My skin broke out like anything. Not initially, but as I used those things in daily basis, slowly my skin started getting irritated.
This face wash actually has very simple packaging, and Aroma Magic is saying that it is not for dry and sensitive skin. I'm coming back to this in a moment. And it has this green color. They say that they don't add artificial color, so I can only hope that it is coming from some natural extracts they're using. It has light gel texture and creates moderate foam.
It has aqua laurel glucoside, which is a surfactant. They have used one emollient. Then they have used tea tree essential oil. Look, many people, they used essential oil, like tea tree essential oil, for acne,
but there are very little evidences that can actually back up the claims, and mostly they assume it is placebo. There are many allergic reactions that have been reported for the use of tea tree oil without much scientific backup. I think we should seek for the safer option for acne issues. And the chemical composition of tea tree oil, if you see, the first ingredient, terpenin, may cause contact dermatitis. I'm not gonna use this for my skin, but it's your choice, your skin, you can do whatever you want to do.
If you see the face wash, you'll see they have written it's not for dry sensitive skin. Okay, dry skin, I understand. Sensitive skin, if someone is getting acne, his or her skin is already vulnerable, sensitive. So it doesn't make any sense to me. They have added lavender essential oil, citrus extract, honey is good, they have added. But overall, the ingredients list, I don't think it's gonna be a very good idea. By looking at the ingredients list, I'm not even sure if they have mentioned the full ingredients list. And I don't recommend this one, face wash. And tea tree oil for acne, I really think we have better ingredients for acne: salicylic acid, zinc, PCA. And many people told me it has worked for them. Good for them. If it's working for you, do use it. But I'm not going to recommend this. I'm not going to use this for my skin because I have issues with the ingredients. They even have claimed that this essential oil is going to prevent blackheads. How they're gonna do it, I have no clue. I have made a video about fragrance and essential oil in skincare. I'm gonna leave the link up there. And the pH of this face wash is good. These are the plus points. The downsides, the claims, the ingredients. According to this ingredients list, they have used more essential oil than honey. And I won't recommend this simply. And one more thing, I'm gonna review all these face washes one by one on my Instagram. And I'm gonna talk about all these ingredients in details. I'm gonna write all these things. Yeah. If you want, you can check my Instagram profile for the detailed reviews, because it's very difficult to, you know, to review 5 face washes in one video. And the reviews are gonna be out very soon. I hope you found this video to be helpful, and thank you so much for watching. And please don't forget to subscribe if you want to watch more videos like this. See you very soon. Bye bye.